P4 chapter 3 coordinate geometry in the x and y plane. Learning objectives. After completing this chapter, you should be able to convert parametric equations into Cartesian form by substitution. Page 17 and 18. Number 2, convert parametric equations into Cartesian form using trigonometric identities. Pages 21, 22 and 23. Third one, understand and use parametric equations of curves and sketch parametric curves. Pages 25 to 26. The last objective, solve coordinate geometry problems involving parametric equations, pages 17 to 26. Second slide, prior knowledge check. There are four questions. They are a very good and standard questions. Number one, rearrange to make T the subject. Part A, x equals 4t minus kt. Part B, y equals 3t squared. Part C, y equals 2 minus 4 ln t. Part D, x equals 1 plus 2 e to the power minus 3t. Example, question number 1a. You can see on the right side, take the t common factor out, then it comes t times or t inside the brackets 4 minus k. Therefore, you divide both sides by 4 minus k to get t as the subject. Similarly, part B, y equals 3t squared, t squared equals y divided by 3, then t equals to plus or minus y divided by 3 square root. Part C, y equals 2 minus 4 ln t, keep 4 ln t on the right side or take 4 minus ln t to the right side, then it comes to 4 ln t equals 2 minus y, then ln t equals 2 minus y divided by 4, then t equals e to the power y minus 2. Similarly, part D. Then the question number 2, write in terms of powers of cosecs. Part A, 4 plus 3 sine squared x, where 4 plus 3 sine squared x, you can write it as 1 minus cos squared x, then you can get the value of cos x as you asked to work it. Sin 2x equals 2 sin x cos x. Therefore, cos x also you can write it in terms of sin. Cot x means cos over sin. Therefore, cos x you can write it. Similarly, part D, 2 cos x plus cos 2x. You can write it as cos 2x as 2 cos squared x minus 1. Then simplify for cos x. Then question number 3. State the range of the following functions. Y equals ln x plus 1 where x is greater than 0. Then you can get the range as PO1 section 2.4 and 4.2, PO2 section 6.1 and PO3 section 4.4, please go through that carefully, the book and the pages. Question number 4 also, you can refer PO or P2 section 2.3. Section 3.1, parametric equations. You can write the x and y coordinates of each point on a curve as function of the third variable. This variable is called a parameter and is often represented by the letter T. Example, you can see a curve is drawn with the y-axis and x-axis. Y goes from 0 to plus 6 and it goes down to minus 1. Similarly, x-axis goes to 0 to 6 and it goes to minus 1 also, where it is given x is the parameter T and y equals qt. Each value of the parameter T defines a point on the curve with coordinates pt and qt. These are parametric equations of the curve. The domain of the parameter tells you the values of T you would need to substitute to find the coordinates of the points on the curve. When t equals 2, x equals 2 squared plus 1 over 2, that is equals to 2.5, and y equals 2 into 2, 4, this corresponds to the point 2.4 and 4. When t equals to 0.5, x, when you substitute, you are getting 2.5, and y you are getting 1. This corresponds to the point 2.5 and 1, where you can see it on the curve. The next slide, you can convert between parametric equations and Cartesian equations by using substitution to eliminate the parameter. There is a notation, a Cartesian equation in two dimensions involves the variables x and y only. You can use the domain and range of the parametric functions, where range is along the y-axis and domain on the x-axis, the resulting Cartesian function. For parametric equations, x, p, in terms of t and y is equals to q in terms of t with Cartesian equation y equals fx. The domain of fx is the range of pt. The range of fx is the range of qt. I will repeat that again. The domain of the function fx is the range of pt, and the range of fx is the range of qt. To confirm, to study, to get to know the clear idea, we can see the example 1, that known as skills analysis. A curve has parametric equations x in terms of t, that is x equals 2t, y in terms of t, y equals t squared. There is a limit t is greater than minus 3 and t is less than 3, where it goes from minus 3 to plus 3. Part A, find the Cartesian equation of the curve in the form y equals fx. B, the state, the domain and range of fx. C, sketch the curve within the given domain for t. Part A, x equals 2t, so t equals x divided by 2, that is equation 1. A Cartesian equation only involves the variable x and y, so you need to eliminate t. Part A, x equals 2t, so that t equals x by 2, it is number 1 equation. Y equals t squared, number 2 equation. A Cartesian equations only involves the variable x and y, so you need to eliminate t. Substitute 1, that is t equals x by 2, into the equation 2, then it comes y equals x over 2 squared, that is equals to x squared by 4. This is a quadratic curve. Part B, x equals 2t, where t is greater than minus 3 and t is less than 3. So the domain of fx equals minus 6, where you substitute minus 3 to t in x equals 2t, that is minus 6, and you substitute 3 to x equals 2t, that comes to 6. So the domain is x is greater than minus 6 and less than 6. The domain of f is the range of the parametric function of 4x. The range of x equals 2t over the domain t is greater than minus 3 and less than 3 is x is greater than minus 6 and less than 6. Part C, we are going to sketch the curve of that, where y-axis, x-axis there. X goes from minus 6 to plus 6. When x equals minus 6, y comes to 9. When x equals 6, y equals 9. So it is a parametric order. Curve is a parabolic curve. You can see it in the diagram. Example 2, that is also a skills, a critical thinking part. A curve has parametric equations x equals ln x t plus 3, y equals 1 over t plus 3, where t is greater than minus 2. Part A, find a equation or the Cartesian equation of the curve of the form y equals fx, where x is greater than k, where k is a constant to be found. Part B, write down the range of fx. Part A, x equals ln t plus 3. When you take the e to the power on both sides, e to the power x equals t plus 3, so e to the x minus 3 equals t. Substituting t equals e to the power x minus 3 into y equals 1 over t plus 5, that goes to 1 over e to the power x minus 3 plus 5, that equals 1 over e to the power x plus 2. When t equals minus 2, x equals ln t plus 3, that is equals to ln 1, that is equals to 0. As t increases, ln t plus 3 increases, so that range of the parametric function for x is greater than 0. The Cartesian equation is y equals 1 over e to the power x plus 2, where x is greater than 0. For further explanations, you can just see the online part on the right side. Everything is given properly. Chapter 3.2, using trigonometric identities. You can use trigonometric identities to convert trigonometric parametric equations into Cartesian form. In this chapter, you will always consider angles measured in radians. Here you have to consider angles measured in radians. Keep that in mind. One example given as example 3, skills. A curve has parametric equations x equals sine t plus 2, y equals cos t minus t, where t belongs to a real number r. A. Show that a Cartesian equation of the curve is x minus 2 squared plus y plus 3 squared equals 1. Part B. Hence, sketch the curve. So, part A, x equals sin t plus 2. So, sin t equals x minus 2. Equation 1, if you want, you can bracket x minus 2. Y is given as cos t minus 3, where cos t equals y plus 3 at the second equation. Now, substitute 1 and 2 into sin squared t plus cos squared t equals 1, where x minus 2 squared brackets plus brackets y plus 3 squared equals 1. Your equations in 1 and 2 are in terms of sin t and cos t, so you need to square them when you substitute. Make sure you square the whole expressions, that you have to put the brackets for safe side. Part B, hence sketch the curve. X axis, y axis given. It is a equation of the circle where the center is 2 and y coordinate is minus 3 and the radius is equals to 1. When you get the point 2 minus 3, that is on the fourth quadrant, so you draw the circle with that center where radius is equals to 1. Example 4. A curve is defined by the parametric equations x equals sin t, y equals sin 2t, where t is greater or equal to minus pi by 2 and less or equal to pi by 2. Part A. Find a Cartesian equation of the curve in the form y equals fx, where x is greater or equal to minus k and less or equal to k, stating the value of the constant k. So, A part, y equals sin 2t, where sin 2t, you can write it as 2 sin t cos t, that is 2x cos t, equation 1. Sin squared t plus cos squared t is identically equal to 1, then cos squared t is identically equal to 1 minus sin squared t, that is equals to 1 minus x squared. So cos t equals square root 1 minus x squared, that is equation 2. Substitute 2 into equation 1. Y equals 2x square root 1 minus x squared. When t equals minus pi by 2, x equals sin minus pi by 2 brackets equals to minus 1. When x equals pi by 2, x equals to sin pi by 2, that is sin 90 equals to 1. The Cartesian equation is y equals 2x square root 1 minus x squared, where x is greater or equals to minus 1, less or equals to 1. So the k value is equals to 1. Part B, write down the range of fx, where y is range greater or equal to minus 1 and y is less or equals to 1. Next, example 5, skills. A curve has a parametric equations x equals cos t plus 2, y equals cos x squared minus 2, where t is greater than 0, t is greater than 0 and t is less than pi. A. Find the equation of the curve in the form y equals fx and state the domain of x for which the curve is defined. Part B. Hence sketch the curve. For this purpose, you can get help from either from your teacher or from. Next, the same example. It is a working part. Part A. X equals cos t plus 2. Cot t equals x minus 2. Then y equals cos x squared t minus 2. Cos x squared t equals y plus 2. That is the second equation. Substitute 1 and 2 into 1 plus cot squared t is identically equal to cos x squared t. So 1 plus x minus 2 whole thing squared equals y plus 2. That is 1 plus x squared minus 4x plus 4 equals y plus 2. So y equals x squared minus 4x plus 3. The range of x cot t plus 2 over the domain t is greater than 0 and less than pi is all the real numbers. So the domain of fx is the x is belongs to a real number r. Part B. Y equals x squared minus 4x plus 3. That is, when you factorize x squared minus 4x plus 3 equals to x minus 3 x minus 1, where quadratic with roots x equals 3 and x equals 1 and y intercept 3, the minimum point is 2 minus 1. So you can see the curve in the diagram part B. 3.3 Curve sketching. Most parametric curves do not result in curves you will recognize and can sketch easily. You can plot any parametric curve by substituting values of the parameter into each equation. Example 6 gives you the what we are telling, that is also skills. Draw the curve given by parametric equation x equals 3 cos t plus 4, y equals 2 sin t, t is greater or equal to 0, less or equal to 2 pi. The t values are, according to the table, goes from 0, pi by 4, pi by 2, 3 pi by 4, pi, 5 pi by 4, 3 pi by 2, 7 pi by 4 and 2 pi. Then the x equals 3 cos t plus 4 goes the values into the second decimal as shown in the table. Then y equals 2 sin t gives you 0, 1.41 and goes up to 0. Then you can plot the curve as below. Then example 7 skills. Draw the curve given by the parametric equations x equals 2t, y equals t squared, where t is equal or greater than minus 1 and t is less or equal to 5. So the table shows t goes from negative 1 to positive 5. X equals 2t when substitute goes from minus 2 to 10, y equals t squared goes from 1 to 25, you can get the values as shown in the table. So x goes from 0 to 10 to minus 2, y goes from 0 to 25 because they all are positive values, then you can see the curve is part of a parabola. It is drawn on the curve. Those are the main important things of this chapter 3, P4. And whatever I did and whatever you are listening, you are understanding, I have to thank you at the end of this, the slides, and thank you once again, and thank you once again for listening and writing and understanding it.